take drugs. Okay? As I said earlier, that actually they want to break the sports record, so they take drugs. And also we cannot blame them actually. See, every country wants the athlete to get gold medal. I mean, so there are of course pressure they receive, so they also try to get the best. Stress from studies, okay? Students who know this thing, I mean parents will be asking, I mean when the children come complain to you, you're saying, what's so stress of studying? Just study, just focus on this one, right? But really if you don't know what the children are suffering.
They caught, so this is the amount they get. And there are still some more
escape and move on. And according to calculation on ADHD testing, this year, 500,000.
Of drinking alcohol in our body itself. As you all see in the picture, from the top till the tip, everything is affected. There's not even one single part of our body will be escaped. From the brains till your veins, everywhere. This is not for excessive alcohol. It is eventually when you take a sip of alcohol itself, the reaction starts taking place. As we see, alcohol level in the body. All of you all know what is shots, right? Yes. Shots are the... Shots are the small glasses which you drink very fast. So, I'm just going to go very briefly. Two shots make you the ability to socialize increase. And then when you take four shots, you don't know what to do. You become too friendly, you start socializing too much. And then for the sixth shot, your muscles and physical coordination is reduced. That is where you see people start moving without having proper standing and air. And then for the eighth shot, loss of body balance, blurred vision, and then the speech uncontrolled. You don't know what you talk. On the 10th shot, loss of muscle coordination. You practically fall. You don't know what you're doing. You think actually you're standing, but actually you're on the floor already. Next, on the 12th shots, sleepy and vomiting. Usually, most of my friends in university, when they talk about these drunk people, they will be like, you know, I saw these people drunk and they was vomiting on the side of the road. They were telling so happily, but once I was doing this research, I found out that that was almost to the one of the most dangerous level already, because vomiting, and there's another two more levels and that's it, you're dead. So don't be proud for vomiting after consuming alcohol. Then for the 14th shot, like continuously, then you get a coma, loss of consciousness. And for the 16th shot and above, suffocation, and then these are the statistics showing the number of alcohol-related deaths in Malaysia. This is for the males. Obviously, males hold the better. Okay, increasing. Yes, the number of deaths, yes, increasing. But eventually, females are also increasing.
Girls and boys, almost like they can build a bridge between the boys.
last time. But now, totally different. The physical contact has increased between girls and boys. The relationship between girls and boys, they are becoming very close. Even air particle can't pass through. Do you know what's the difference? They change to the new
meaning. So what are the effects when the sisters view this wrong relationship? First of all, when you can't control your desire, your relationship has gone really wild at the stage, you'll be facing early pregnancy issues. And these are the statistics on the teenage pregnancy in Malaysia. You can see that the year of 2010 it is divided into two, married and unmarried. We have 1,521 and a total of 5,962 couples. And the year of 2013, just in 3 months, which is January to February, we've got unmarried teenage pregnancy cases, which is 1,048, which is almost the same in the whole year of 2010.
This is a survey conducted in three public and private universities. Very well-known private industry. And you can see, the students can spend more time on social media than daily revision. They go to the class and they study, but they don't do their revision. But they can spend time on social media. And also sleeping more than 9 hours per day. I had given them a choice to state how many hours they slept. And they chose more than 9 hours per day. This means they skip their classes for sleeping. Wow. So these students are just like wasting your parents' money and they're just sleeping. Validating relationship. Again, I'm stressing relationships as the group presented earlier. It's not a bad thing, but how? They're wasting time on with their partners. You can see those who are always in love, they're always on their phone, talking, texting. But then you don't realize that you're using a lot of time on it. So I have a personal experience regarding relationship. A close friend of mine, we were both classmates, and he had exams the next day. And but his girlfriend called him, "I want to talk to you." So they spoke on the phone for 2 or 3 hours. And then he thought he wanted to study for the exam. But then, no, the girlfriend said, "I want to Skype with you." And they ended up Skyping the whole night, and he didn't study. And he went to the exam hall, he was sitting beside me, and just looked at me, and looked at paper, and just gave a blank face. Then he said, he whispered to me, "I don't know what to do." Then I had no comments. It's his own mistake. You didn't study because of your relationship issues. So you can't give an excuse, "I don't know." It's your own fault. So you can see that relationships also cause time wastage.
There is enough nicotine in 4 or 5 cigarettes to kill an average adult if ingested in whole. Now, let's go to the secondhand smoke. Secondhand smoke contains more than 50 cancer-causing chemical compounds. This pipe goes to smoking parents. Parents who smoke tell me, "I smoke outside of the house. I don't smoke on the inside. So how is my child going to get infected?" Here, 85% of cigarette smoke goes into the air. So tell me, where do you think it goes from there? And for smoking parents, if you smoke around a child, by the age of 5, he would have inhaled the equivalent of 102 packs of cigarette. So imagine the amount of damage this is going through, because the nicotine level in a child is way lower compared to an adult. Kids of the age of 10 and above, I've known friends who have started smoking at the age of 8, 9. Thus, the rate of smoking is increasing from 80,000 to 100,000 per day worldwide. Kids are being exposed to cigarettes per day from 80,000 to 100,000. Studies show that 1 in 5 teens aged 13 to 15 smoke cigarettes. 1,000 youths under the age of 18 start smoking every day. This is equivalent to entire high school. 1 out of 4